Our next speaker will be Dr. Kenneth Calamia, professor of medicine and member of the Division of Rheumatology at Mayo Clinic in Florida. Dr. Calamia's interests are hunting, fishing, and Behcet's disease, maybe in that order. Anyway, it's good to have you with us to present a lecture on the approach to oral lesions in rheumatic conditions. Dr. Calamia.
Glad to be here with you all. I think this talk will dovetail nicely with the last presentation that we heard, and we'll be looking at some of the other factors that will allow us to recognize other forms of rheumatic diseases. No disclosures, we'll talk a little bit off-label on some of the treatments. And we'll look at mucosal lesions, and we'll expand it a little bit to include genital lesions, some skin stuff that are seen in connective tissue diseases and rheumatoid arthritis, infectious arthritis, reactive arthritis, and then talk a bit about aphthous stomatitis, which is a very common clinical problem, oftentimes suggesting the possibility of Behcet's disease, which is a pretty rare condition in this country. And we'll talk about some mimics that we need to consider when we're seeing patients with a lot of mucosal problems. Some rheumatologists from the United States and Europe got together recently and proposed this definition for RMD, or rheumatic and musculoskeletal diseases. I'm sure they met at some Greek island and had not too much else to do, but came up with this definition. But it's they hit on some very important factors. There's about 200 different kind of rheumatic diseases. So we've talked about some, and we've seen scleroderma, rheumatoid arthritis, lupus, but there's a bunch of other things, the vasculitides, a number of disorders, all of which may present with an arthritis, a polyarthritis, an inflammatory arthritis. So we can diagnose with the algorithm and with the recognition of signs and symptoms and testing that allows to diagnose rheumatoid arthritis and some other things. But when all the tests are negative, you really have to turn away from the joints, look at some of the other things that are going on to help you make a diagnosis. Any place, these disorders involve multiple organ systems. So as primary care physicians, as specialists, dealing with rheumatic diseases, you really have to be quite a generalist in internal medicine. You have to be familiar with lots of different organ systems. So just first of all, as we heard, is this an inflammatory problem, or is this osteoarthritis, or a non-inflammatory problem? Is it musculoskeletal? As we heard from our last speaker, lots of things to be considered. A lot of generalists are not easily